Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. This is the actual 5 out of 11 dahil I noticed in the last video I miscount. So yeah, sure na ako na 5 out of 11 na ako. Sadly, I wasn't able to finish all 11 for Pride Month and ramdam ko na yun burnout. So I don't know, for me, I really don't want to create lackluster characters, very uninspired characters. And I really noticed that when I was designing the other five. So I'll be giving myself more time to work on these last characters. So at the moment, our last color for now is violet. In the original Pride flag, it was actually two. It was not violet only. It was indigo, which meant for spirituality, and violet, which means serenity. I decided on combining the two meanings to create this character. So, I want this design to be a chill-looking dude. Just like the last video, I also took the meaning of the color from color theory so that I have more material to work it with. For this one, I actually looked up what characteristics spiritual people have. Based on my research, spiritual people are humble and down to earth. They are also at peace and less likely to get agitated. And they are very relaxed and comfortable. So all these descriptions helps me a lot in designing this character. It gives me like a direction on how I should take him. So one of my main goal is for this character to look like a very chill dude, someone you feel like you could hang out with. He was quite a challenge, to be honest, for me when I was conceptualizing him, since he is a humble dude. He doesn't wear, or based on that personality, he's not supposed to wear clothes that would make him stand out so much. So he should be plain looking, but at the same time not too plain that he will look out of place from the other characters that I designed. So I have to think of a good balance. So I searched the internet for some clothes. Aminin ko, para nagsha-shopping ako, tas sa maganda tis, di ko kailangan bumayad. I picked the clothes that I personally feel comfortable to wear. So I chose a denim jacket, this long sleeve polo, ripped jeans, and sneakers. I thought that the denim jacket makes his character look interesting. At the same time, it won't make his design stand out too much. I also made him unbutton his shirt so that, you know, it'll give him look less uptight, more relaxed. And I gave him shaggy hair to show, like, you know, he's not that type of guy that worries about the style of his hair, and some highlights to add some personality. I also gave him some prayer beads for a necklace, since I noticed, or since I saw, like, some people actually wear prayer beads as a necklace, so that it'll give his character some spiritual vibes. Last minute, I also realized that the color is similar to the Ace flag. So I changed the pants last minute and made it black to reflect that. To be honest, I was also like really considering if I should go with the idea to match with the Ace flag, because I like how I like how the pants already look, but the black pants slowly warmed up to me, so I kept that. And this is his final design. There, and this is his character art. I personally want to dress up as him. I've always wanted to own a denim jacket. Slight parinig? Yes. Ashamed? No. Also, it was kinda like relaxing and within my comfort zone to draw him, since he is the most human out of the ones I made so far. So, everyone, this is Ralph, the mediator. Okay, I have to admit, personally, I'm still not yet sure with his title, so I might change it down the line. I don't know, maybe. Yeah, guys, go to the story. Go!
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There lived a boy who was an outcast, not even considered to be human by anyone. He was treated like a robot, someone who did not know how to love. He was different, but at the same time, he knew that it was normal. The only person who understood him was his best friend, Raina. They were inseparable. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. He always fought back. He was always aggressive. He was never silent. And every time, there was something within him trying to break out, trying to consume him. At first, it was nothing, too gentle to be felt. But fight after fight, it grew stronger than before. Inevitably, he exploded and had let his emotions out. The powerful force within him got out, causing destruction to anyone within a meter of him. After this, he feared a future where this unknown power inside him would run rampant and would hurt Raina, the only person he cared about. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Unlike Ralph, you don't usually think twice about these numbers. Each number is valuable in controlling himself. Controlling himself not just for his safety, but especially for his love, Raina. It's what keeps him calm. It's his mantra. Emotions are truly powerful. Every tear, every laughter, and every scream. If they want to go out, they will find a way to get out. It's your choice whether you give in to them or you learn how to control them.